Good day everyone! Ang video na ito ay bilang paggunita sa ika-130 karawan ni George Polya. Sino nga ba si George Polya? Si George Polya is the father of problem solving. And according to him, there are four general principles in solving a problem. The first one is the preparation. Next is thinking, then insight, and lastly, verification. And there are two strategies or approaches in solving a problem. The first one is the inductive reasoning, which forms a conclusion based on the example. This may or may not be true. And the second one is the deductive reasoning, which having conclusions by applying general principles and procedures. Pero, para mas mapaliwanag yan, mukhang kailangan natin ng panibagong video. So, bago ang lahat, hit like and subscribe.
Now, let's proceed to the five different strategies in problem solving.
In this section, we'll study about number sequence fit pattern. In order to find the missing term, we must look or find for a pattern. In my first example, 7, 14, 21, 28, 35, and so on. So you can see, if you observe each number is obtained by adding 7 to the preceding number. Add 7. And to my second example, you can see it is obtained by multiplying by 3 each to the preceding number. Because 8 times 3, 24, 24 times 3, 81, and so on. And to my main problem, there are some blocks that you will answer. So ito na nga ulit tayo sa ating main problem. Kung makikita nyo sa ating unang term ay masyadong malaki. Kaya dito muna tayo sa ating magkasunod na term. Kung mapapansin nyo dito, ang 27 ay divisible by 3. Kaya pag dinivide nyo siya, ilalabas sa 9. At ang 9 pag dinivide sa 3, ilalabas sa 3. Kaya para makuha natin ang mga blankong ito, i-divide ko muna itong 2 term, 1, 2, 3, ika-apat na term para makuha itong 5th term. So, 243 divided by 3 is equal to 24 divided by 3, 3 divided by 3 is 1. So, 81 ang magiging sagot. Kaya pag, para maalaman nyo kung tama nga, i-divide nyo ulit yung 81 para lumabas itong pasunod nyo ang term. So, dito naman tayo sa ating unang term para makuha yung ating pangalawang term. Masyado siyang malaki kaya sasagutan na natin. Ito ang lalabas ng sagot niya pag dinivide dito sa 3. 6561 divided by 3 is equal to 2187.
In this part, I will going to discuss all about sequence, but in a diagram form. So let's have for example, how many flowers will there be in 46 figure? So as we can see in the figure, there are a lot of flowers here. And to solve for the 46 figure, we have to remember the formula. The general formula here is a sub n equals a sub 1 plus the quantity n minus 1 times d or the common difference. So the first term or the a1, the n is the nth term, the d is the common difference. So let's now move on to the solution. As you can see in the screen, there are the given diagram wherein the a1 or the first term is 4. N is 46 and the common difference is 3. So let's just substitute the givens from the formula. First term is 4 plus the quantity of 46 minus 1 times d, which is the common difference is 3. So just simplify 4 plus 45 times 3. 45 times 3 is 135. Just follow the operation, then 135 plus 4 is equals to 139. So meaning we have 139 flowers in the 46 term.
The next approach that we are going to use in solving a problem is the guess and check. So here's the problem. Lara, Noah, and Dana are members of the same family. Noah is 5 years older than Lara. Dana is 6 years older than Noah. Today, Lara is celebrating her 5th birthday. The sum of their 3 ages is 31. How old is each one of them? Sabi sa problem, Lara is celebrating her 5th birthday. Kung kaya't si Lara ay 5 years old. Sabi naman dito, Noah is 5 years older than Lara. Kung kaya't 5 plus 5 is equals to 10. So let's proceed to Dana. Dana is 6 years older than Noah. Madadagdagan na 6. So 10 plus 6 is equals to 16. So ngayon naman, once na pinag-add natin silang tatlo, dapat ang kalabasan niya is 31. So tingnan natin. 5 plus 10 is equals to 15. And 15 plus 16 is equals to 31. So therefore, Lara is 5 years old, Noah is 10 years old, and Dana is 16.
So hey guys, for our next approach is work backwards. Pero teka lang, kita ba? So, yan, mas kita ako. So, again, work backwards. Here's our problem. Paul has money in his piggy bank. His mom adds $5 to the bank. Paul takes out $2 to buy an ice cream, but adds $10 his grandmother gave him for his birthday. At the end of the day, Paul empties his piggy bank to count his money and finds he has a total of $20. So here's our question, main question. How much money did Paul have in his piggy bank at the start of the day? So let X be Paul's money at the start of the day. So, para makuha natin yung x is x minus x sub 1 is minus 5. So, ang x sub 1 naman is x sub 2 plus 2. Ganun din, sunod, x sub 3 minus 10. So, x sub 3 natin is $20. Yun yung pera ni Paul nung matapos ang araw. So, para makuha natin yung x sub 2, we must subtract 10 from x sub 3. So, ang x sub 3 natin is 20. 20 minus 10 is equals to x sub 2. Bakit natin siya minus? Kasi work backwards nga. Kung ano yung dinagdag natin, siyang ima-minus natin. So, 20 minus 10 is equals to 10. So, ang sagot natin sa x sub 2 is $10. Yan, $10. Now, para mabuhay ang ating x sub 1, we must x sub 2 plus 2 is equals to x sub 1. So, ang ating x sub 2 is equivalent to $10. Lagay lang natin. $10. So, saan ang galing yung 2? Yun yung kinuha ni Paul para bumili ng ice cream. But, tandaan natin, work backwards. Kaya yung minus natin, yun yung i-add natin. So, 10 plus 2 is equals to $12. So, ang x sub 1 natin is equivalent to $12. Now, para makuha natin ng x. So, ang x sub 1 natin is $12. Tandaan natin. So, $12. Para makuha natin, x sub 1 minus 5 is equals to x. So, i-ano lang natin, x sub 1 is $12. Yan. So, $12 minus 5 is equals to $7. Ang galing. $7. So, yan. X natin is $7. Therefore, Paul's money at the start of the day is $7.
So hey guys, in this video, I'll teach you how to solve two-digit number problem. So here's our problem. The sum of the digits of a two-digit number is 11. If we interchange the digits, then the new number formed is 45 less than the original. Find the original number. So for our solution, this is step 1. Assign our variables. Let x equals 1's digit and y equals 10's digit. Then we will have x plus y equals 11. Then we will transpose variable x. So our answer will be x is equals to 11 minus y. This will be our equation number 1. Step 2. Convert digits to number. Original number is yx 10 plus x. Then interchange number is x times 10 plus y. We will put x times 10 plus y equals yx 10 plus x minus 45. Then 10x plus y is equals to 10y plus x minus 45. put minus x to both sides. So that will be 10x minus x plus y equals 10y minus 45. After, put negative y to both sides. So that will be 10x minus x equals 10y minus y minus 45. Then add 45 to both sides. So that will be 10x minus x plus 45 equals 10y minus y. Then rewrite equation with y on the left hand side. So that will be 10y minus y equals 10x minus x plus 45. After that, combine like terms. So that will be 10y minus y equals 10x minus x plus 45. Then minus it, 9y equals 9x plus 45. So this will be our equation number 2. After that, substitute equation 1 into equation 2. So that will be 9y equals 9, 11 minus y plus 45. Solve. 9y equals 99 minus 9y plus 45. Then we will transpose variable y. So that will be 9y plus 9y equals 99 plus 45. Solve. That will be 18y equals 144. So our answer would be the tens digit is 8, then the ones digit is 11 minus 8 equals 3. So our final answer would be 83.